Hi, I'm from Social Research Insights, and today I'm going to explain you how to perform Kaiser-Meyer-Ulikian sample adequacy measure for exploratory factor analysis through LibreOffice CalC, which is installed in Ubuntu 14.04. The mission of Social Research Insights is to promote open source software for both academic and corporate research needs. And coming to this subject, KMO sample adequacy measure, in short we refer to as MSA, measure of sample adequacy, is regarded as one of the important statistical tests while performing exploratory factor analysis, along with the Bartlett test of sphericity and Hytoski's test for matrix singularity. All these tests are performed on the correlation matrix. In case of the Bartlett test, the null hypothesis is that the correlation matrix is an identity matrix, and the alternative hypothesis must be true in order to perform the factor analysis. In the same fashion, when doing KMO MSA, I mean KMO sample adequacy measure, the partial correlations must be zero. So the KMO measure usually above 0.5 is regarded as a suitable situation for exploratory factor analysis. We just require two important matrices apart from correlation matrix to compute the Kaiser-Meyer-Ulikian sample adequacy measure. That is the inverse matrix and the correlation matrix. And from the inverse matrix, we are going to compute the inverse the partial correlation matrix. So in precise, we need three matrices. That is the number one correlation matrix, which is computed from the sample dataset, and the inverse of the correlation matrix and the diagonal values, the square root of the diagonal values as a vector. And by using the inverse correlation matrix and the diagonal values, we are going to compute the partial correlation matrix, and the formula is going to be R inverse divided by matrix multiplication diagonal vector to that of transpose of the diagonal vector. So this is the partial correlation matrix, and once we prepare the partial correlation matrix with the help of the sum of the squares of the correlations for a given variable summed up again by squaring the values is used to compute the KMO sample adequacy measure. So I'm going to repeat once again. After we compute the correlation matrix, inverse correlation matrix, we compute the partial correlation matrix with the help of the inverse correlation, by dividing the inverse correlation matrix with the square root of the diagonal values as a vector, and after that we have to compute the sum of the squares of the correlation coefficients for a given data variable. In my study I have 5 data variables, so I will be having 5 such values. And finally, again I have to take the sum of the squares of these correlation coefficients for the correlation matrix, and straight away we will go to the partial correlation matrix and we repeat the same action, which means we compute the sum of the squares of the partial correlations, and it will be repeated for the rest of the variables, and finally we obtain the sum of the squares of these partial correlations to compute the final measure of the KMO. So these individual values will be used to compute the KMO sample adequacy measure to test if this particular variable has any partial correlation effect on the data matrix. So based on the computer values, we are going to assess whether the partial correlations in the data variable are valid or not. Usually the partial correlations must be zero in order to proceed ahead for the exploratory factor analysis. That is the null hypothesis. I mean alternative hypothesis, and null hypothesis is that the partial correlations do exist in the data matrix, and alternative hypothesis, partial correlations do not exist in the data matrix. So I compute the correlation matrix with the help of the matrix multiplications in LibreOffice Calc. We have wonderful functions to compute the correlation matrix. If you see that the diagonal values are 1 and there are valid correlation coefficients for the study variables. If you observe, this is the correlation coefficient for the study variable 1 and 2. This is x1 and x2. That is minus. So there is a negative but poor correlation between x1 and x2. So this is a correlation matrix, and after that I have to compute the sum of the squares of, you can see that in the formula bar, sum of the square of the correlations minus 1, which means I don't want this 1 diagonal value. So I subtracted this diagonal value, which is 1, in order to avoid the oversimplification. So sum of the squares of these correlations are computed with the help of the function sum square, and finally the sum of the squares on the sum of the squares of these correlation coefficients computed for the final value of the KMU sample adequacy measure. And we have to go ahead and we compute the inverse of the correlation matrix, which simply with the help of M inverse, a function known as M inverse is available through LibreOffice Calc. We just have to use that function and keep the correlation matrix within the parentheses, and we'll get the inverse correlation matrix. And take the diagonal values and square root them. You can see the square root of the diagonal value. So if I see second value, square root of the diagonal value, square root of the diagonal value. So we have to take the square root of the diagonal values, and with the help of this inverse matrix and the square root of the diagonal values, we compute the partial correlation matrix. We just have to divide the partial correlation matrix by the vector of the diagonal, the square root of the diagonal elements of the partial correlation matrix. See, you can see that, you know, G42 to K46, G42 to this highlighted in blue color, there is inverse matrix divided by matrix multiplication. We can do matrix multiplication with the help of a function M mult. And M42 means this the square root of the root values of the diagonal elements of the partial the inverse correlation matrix to the transpose of the same vector. So this is the partial correlation matrix. We have to repeat this the sum of the squares of the correlation coefficients for the partial correlation matrix the same way as we have done for the correlation matrix. See, here you can see the sum of the squares of sum square, the partial correlations minus 1 to get rid of the diagonal element, and we just have to copy paste this value to the rest of the variable so that it automatically, LibreOffice automatically compute the sum squares of the sum of the squares of the partial correlation coefficients. And finally we have to once again repeat the sum of the squares for the sum of the squares of the partial correlation coefficients of the partial correlation matrix. And finally we just have to substitute these values. If you can see that sum of the squares of the correlations for correlation matrix divided by sum of the squares of the correlations plus sum of the squares of the partial correlations, that is what precisely we do in see here, sum of the squares of the correlations by sum of the squares of the correlations plus sum of the squares of the partial correlations. This is what is KMU measure. So if you see that I substituted the value sum of the squares of the correlations divided by the sum of the squares of the correlations plus sum of the squares of the partial correlations, we just have to copy paste this value to the rest of the variables in rest of the cells in order to compute the same sum of the squares of KMU measure for rest of the variables. In order to know the sample adequacy, if this particular variable, in order to detect whether a particular variable deserve for the factor analysis or not. So the final value of the this is for the multivariate data set. I mean final value for the the summary value for the total data set, we just have to repeat the same things. See, sum square of the sum of the squares of the correlations divided by sum square of the sum of the squares of the partial correlations plus the sum square of the sum of the squares of the correlation matrix by same value plus sum square of the sum of the squares of the partial correlation matrix, and we'll get the final value of the. So now coming to the assessment, somebody has given this assessment criteria. Anything, if the KMVO measure is less than 0.5, then it is unacceptable. The data set is unsuitable for factor analysis. And anything between 0.5 to 0.6 is miserable, 0.6 to 0.7 is mediocre, 0.7 to 0.8 is middling, 0.8 to 0.9 is meritorious, anything above 0.9 is marvelous. So this is the assessment criteria. So in our case, the value is exactly 0.5, and some of the values for the data variables even less than 0.5. So we may not be able to continue the exploratory factor analysis by using this data. In other words, this data may not be able to explain the study factors after performing the exploratory factor analysis. Otherwise, the data is not adequate to perform the exploratory factor analysis. So this is the way we compute the Kaiser-Meyer-Ollakin sample adequacy measure in LibreOffice Calc to perform the exploratory factor analysis. Thank you.